According to Bhagavad Gita, the sum total of the 24 elements described herein is called the Yonir Mahat Brahma. The sum total of the living entities is impregnated into this Yonir Mahat Brahma, and they are born in different forms, beginning from Brahma down to the insignificant ant. In the Srimad Bhagavatam and other Vedic literatures, the sum total of the 24 elements, Pradhana, is also described as Yonir Mahat Brahma. It is the source of the birth and subsistence of all living entities. Thus ends the Bhaktivinoda purport and translation to Canto 3, Chapter 26, Text number 11 of Srimad Bhagavatam. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namah Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminite Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschati Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. These are the words spoken by Bhagavan Kapila to his mother Devahuti. In reply to her question about knowing the characteristics about the Supreme Lord and his energies, different energies. Why she wants to know about that? Because whatever is manifest in this world and whatever is not manifest in this world, the cause is the Lord and the Lord's energies. So unless we have a clear understanding of the fundamentals of fundamental principles of material nature, it is very difficult to operate in this world. Just like any gadget, if you don't understand how it operates, how it functions, how it behaves, then you cannot take the benefit from that gadget. Similarly, this material, whole material cosmos is like a machine, like a gadget. And if we know how to, if we understand its different elements, just like the gadget, you understand different parts and how it is associated with the different other parts, how it interacts and communicates with the different other parts, then you can master that gadget and you can even do research on that and improve on that gadget. This is what is going on in the research field in the outside world. Just like this material body also consists of so many cells. If you understand the anatomical, the biological, the physical, the chemical, chemistry of this body, then you can play around with this body. Similarly, if we understand the material creation, of course, our goal is not to play around, but to stop the play. Because the playing around is very tough in this world. Krishna has explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Daivihi esha gunamayi mama maya duratiya. This field of play is extremely tough for anybody to win over. We will always be the loser, never the winner. Therefore, Krishna says, if you surrender unto me, then you will win over this material nature. Material nature is very powerful. So to understand how powerful it is, first of all, we have to know the basics of material nature. If you don't even understand what the constitutes material nature, then there's no way to proceed forward. So therefore, Mother Devahuti is asking Lord Kapila to describe the characteristics of the Supreme Lord and his different energies in detail. So Lord Kapila is beginning to describe. In the previous verse, we saw Lord Kapila talking about Pradhana and Prakriti. He has used two terms. And Prabhupada is explaining I'm sorry. Lord Kapila is continuing to explain those two terms in the following verses, beginning from this verse which is under discussion today. So the previous translation went on like this. The Supreme Personality of God had said, the unmanifested eternal combination of the three modes is the cause of the manifest state and is called Pradhana. It is called Prakriti when in the manifested stage of existence. And then what is that Pradhana is being listed here in this sequence of verses. We will see that little shortly. Before that, let's little touch upon Pradhana and Prakriti. Prabhupada has explained Pradhana as the unmanifested state of material nature, or the gross and the subtle material elements in its subtler state. When there are no material varieties which can be observed or seen, that is the state of Pradhana. But when you can differentiate the material energy or material nature, as described from this verse under discussion today, that is called Prakriti. But when these material elements, when there is no time element and there is no interaction between the material elements, it simply remains in a consolidated state, that is called Pradhana. But when it is in action, that is called Prakriti. So Prabhupada explains Pradhana is something like a lump of matter. It's a consolidation of all material elements. Totally there are 25 described, 24 in this verse. And further one more element is added, thereby making the number to 25. So totally there are 25 material elements, original material elements, which is the cause of this creation. Just like a computer may have about 1,000 parts, I'm just saying. This total material creation is a combination of 24 plus 1, 25 elements. That's it. So our study is complete about this material world. This way, studying text number 11 to 14 of Srimad Bhagavatam, third canto. And you can master the whole subject of material creation. Just text number 11, 12, 13, 14, only four verses. That's all. Just like Lord Krishna explained the whole Bhagavatam in a nucleus form in four verses to Lord Brahma, here Lord Kapila is describing the whole material creation in just four verses. And Pradhana is eternal, but Prakriti is not eternal because Prakriti keeps changing, continues. Prakriti means material nature. We can see constantly changes happening in this material creation. So therefore it is not eternal. That is explained. Prabhupada gave a very nice example. Just like you see in this material world, everything is changing. We understand there are six changes in this material creation. We all undergo six changes. First, there is birth. Then, there is growth and staying for some time, but byproducts. Then, dwindling state. And finally, we vanish. So, there is constant change. This material world is constantly changing. So Prakriti is constantly changing. And Prabhupada explains that according to Bhagavad Gita, the sum total of the 24 elements described herein is called Yonir Mahat Brahma. Anybody remembers the verse in the Bhagavad Gita? Which verse, which chapter? It's chapter 14, text number 3. Krishna says, Mama Yonir Mahat Brahma Tasmin Garbam Dadamyaham Sambhava Sarva Bhutani Tato Bhavati Bharata. So that is the reference which Prabhupada is making here. And so that verse is elaborated by Lord Kapila in these verses in the Bhagavatam, this portion of Bhagavatam. So where Lord Krishna has summarized this in the Bhagavad Gita. In other words, Bhagavad Gita is actually a summary of all the Vedic literatures. In essence, Krishna explains all the detailed Sankhya and all the other yoga philosophies in a nutshell in the Bhagavad Gita. That's why Prabhupada said, if we can study this one book, Bhagavad Gita, thoroughly, probably you don't even require to study other Vedic literatures, including Bhagavatam. But if you study thoroughly Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada also said, if you study Bhagavad Gita thoroughly, you can answer any kind of question in the world. Everything is there in the Bhagavad Gita. But for more details, you can refer Srimad Bhagavatam. So Krishna is saying that, Mama Yonir Mahat Brahma Tasmin Garbham Dadamyaham. So Krishna is saying, Mama Yonir Mahat Brahma. This Mahat Brahma is being referred here as total material elements, which is called Brahman. And Mama, it is my created material energy in its consolidated form. So into this total material energy or material nature, unmanifested material nature, Tasmin Garbham Dadamyaham, I impregnate all the varieties of living entities. Sambhava Sarva Bhutanam, and this Pradhana, from that Pradhana manifests Mahatattva. And this Mahatattva is the breeding source of all living entities. So Prabhupada gives a simple example, just like mother's womb. From the mother's womb, you know, she gives birth to different kinds of children, male, female, etc. Similarly, the material nature or Mahatattva is the breeding source of all living entities. So, Sambhava Sarva Bhutani Tato Bhavati Bharata. I manifest all the living entities by impregnating the material nature. That's what Krishna meant there. Which is full of varieties. So then that becomes Prakriti. When there is variety manifest in this world, it is called as Prakriti. Prabhupada gave a nice example of what is Prakriti in one lecture. We know the famous verse in the Brahma Samhita. Yasya prabha prabhavato jagadanda koti koti shvaseshu vasudadi vibhuti bhinnam tad brahma nishkalam anantam asesha bhutam govindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. So in this verse, Lord Brahma points out about this aspect of Prakriti. This is vasudadi vibhuti bhinnam. Vasudha means actually referring to the earth. Adi means there are many planetary systems in this creation of the Lord. So vasudadi vibhuti bhinnam. Vibhuti means opulences and varieties. There cannot be any opulence without varieties, isn't it? Opulence means variety. This is why we say Raj Bhog to the Lord. Why? Because it's varieties of items, rich items offered to the Lord for his pleasure. So there cannot be opulence without variety. So this material world is another opulent creation of the Lord. Is a magnificent opulent creation of the Lord. The Lord's opulence manifest in this creation. So Vasudadi Vibhuti, therefore it is described as Vibhuti. This material creation is Vibhuti of the Lord. Bhinnam, it's full of varieties. As I described, opulence means varieties. So Lord Brahma very nicely describes Vibhuti Bhinnam. This world is full of varieties. Originating from one, that is Pradhana. If that one gets split or multiplied or expands, this is the Lord expands, the Lord's energy also expands. So the Lord expands in two forms. One is the Vishnu expansions, one more is the material expansions. First is the creation of the material energy called Pradhana. Then that Pradhana further expands, and that expansion is described here in this verse today, which is numbering 24. So before getting into this, so what Prabhupada would like to share? So Prabhupada said, this material world, if you want to know what is the variety, just like you see the moon and the sun, contrasting creations of the Lord. The moon, it's they say it's below 200 degrees centigrade. Prabhupada said, it's so cool. And the sun is exactly opposite. It's practically fire. You see the contrasting variety, fire, heat, and coolness. It's variety in the Lord's creation. So this is variety. These are the later varieties, because in Pradhana, nothing exists. Neither the sun, nor the moon, nor coolness, nor heat, nor fire, nor space. Nothing exists. Nor even time. Even Kala is not manifest in the state of Pradhana. And the interactions, the cause and effect principle is also not manifest in Pradhana. And the past, present and future also does not exist in Pradhana. So Pradhana is an unmanifested state. But it has got all the varieties in it. It is, in other words, we call it as potential. Just like we say the soul, it has got its inner potential, nature to become Krishna conscious naturally. It has got the potential. So this Pradhana is actually a potential material energy, but not manifesting its potency for us. So here it is described, Panchabir Brahma. So what is that? What is that potential material energy? Aggregate material energy. Panchabi, the five gross elements. Lord Kapila himself will list out. You will be wondering where is the source of all these elements listed. It's actually in this portion of the Bhagavatam. So Panchabi, the first list is five gross elements. Then Panchabir, the second five, is referring to the five subtle elements. Then Satubihi, the four subtle elements, internal senses. Then Dashabihi, 10 senses, 5 for acquiring knowledge and 5 for working action. Then Eta Chatur Vimshatikam, Chatur means 4, Vimshati means 20, so Chatur Vimshati means 24. So Etat means these, Chatur Vimshatikam, 24 elements, Ganam, as it is counted, the aggregate of this 24, Pradhanikam Viduhu, it is understood, it is known as Pradhana. So these are the, this is what comprises Pradhana. And what are the divisions that Lord Kapila goes on to describe? The next three verses, we'll read out quickly. Mahabhutani Panchaiva, five elements which are referred are called Mahabhutani. Even Krishna talks about in the Bhagavad Gita also in the 13th chapter. So Mahabhutani, the five gross elements is called Mahabhuta. It's the original five elements created by the Lord. What are they? Bhumi Apo, Agnir, Marun, Nabaha. Bhumi, earth. Apaha, water. Agni, fire. Marut, air or wind. Nabaha, sky. Then Tanmatrani cha Tavanti Gandhadini Matani me. Tanmatra. Then there are five subtle elements. Gandha Adini, beginning with smell. Gandha Adi means etc. So Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, Sparsha, like that we have that list going on. And Shabda. These are the five subtle elements. Matani me, Lord Kapila is saying, this is considered according to me. Then, Indriyani dasha shrotram, there are 10 senses. Tvak drik rasana nasikaha vakkara ucharanau medhram payur dashama uchate. So the 10 senses are described here as for acquiring knowledge and for working. For practical action, totally numbering 10. The auditory sense, the sense of taste, the tactile sense, the sense of sight, the sense of smell, the five knowledge acquiring senses, and the active organs are vak, karana, charana, medra, and payuhu. Speaking purpose, the mouth. Karaha, the hands, charana, the two legs, medram, the generating organ, the genitals, and payuhu, the evacuating organ. Dashama uchite, these are the 10 working sense organs. Then the last list. Mano buddhi rahankara chittam ityantaratmakam chaturda lakshate bedaha. The four internal senses are described here as mind, manaha, buddhi, intelligence, ahankara, ego, and chittam, contaminated consciousness. Iti antaratmakam, these are considered to be internal. Chaturdha, but how do you understand the difference? It's very interesting. Lord Kapila says it's very difficult to differentiate them, but it is understood by lakshate bedaha. The beda, the difference is understood by vritti, vrittya lakshana rupaya. It is understood by its characteristic features. Then Lord Kapila goes on to describe the characteristic feature of each of these elements. So by its functions, by its characteristic features, you can differentiate them and understand them separately. So coming back to this Mahatattva, which is the aggregate of these 24 elements, Prabhupada very nicely describes in one place, just like there is Mahatattva, which is also Krishna's creation. Krishna is also called in Bhagavatam as, he's referred by one name called Mukunda. And when he addresses Mukunda, immediately Shukadeva Goswami describes his lotus feet as Mahat Padam. So Mahatattva, for Mahatattva there is Mahat Padam. It's a beautiful explanation by Prabhupada. So Mahat Padam is a famous verse where it is described, Samashita ye pada pallava plavam, Mahat Padam punya yasho murare, Bhavam budir, Vatsa Padam param padam, Padam padam yet vipadam natesha. Mahat Tattva is the source of fear also. Actually, that Krishna describes in the 13th chapter. These 24 elements further expands, causing fear also. So to counter that fear, there is the Mahat Pada of Krishna, Krishna Chandra. So, Samashita ye pada pallava plavam Mahat Padam punya yasho murari. Murari, Krishna. His lotus feet is actually Mahat Padam. It is the source of all fearlessness. It is the source of the Mahat Tattva. And it is also the resting place of Mahat Tattva. Prabhupada calls it as Krishna's lotus feet at the resting place of Mahat Tattva. So therefore, if we want to come out of the interaction of these 24 elements, which is binding the soul to this world, then we have to take shelter of another Mahat, which is Krishna. So one Mahat is binding, and that binding is very great. That's why it's called Mahat. Similarly, there is another Mahat to counter this Mahat, and that is Mahat Padam, Krishna Chandra's lotus feet. So if we take shelter of the Lord's lotus feet, then we can cross over this material existence. So it is described that if we take shelter of Krishna, complete shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, then Bhava Ambudhi Vatsa Padam Param Padam 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 Yat Vipadam Natesham. This entire material existence, which is considered like an ocean of water, becomes like a watering container in a calf's hoof print. Then 10 such water pits you can jump at a time without difficulty. So that is the idea presented by Lord Kapila. Unfortunately, these material elements, with all its analysis, why are we understanding? Just to understand the vibhuti of the Lord and the vichitra, the varied creation of the Lord, and to appreciate the Lord's creation. And to attach that variety and that opulence to the Lord and surrender to the Lord. But there are atheistic philosophers, just like in Europe, they also study Sankhya. This is actually called Sankhya. Sankhya means split, divide and study analytically, very deeply. It's called Sankhya. Comes from the Sankhya, to count and understand. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So they also count 24 elements. And the 25th element is Kala. The 26th element is soul or the super soul. But unfortunately, the atheistic Sankhya philosophers, they miss out this 26th element, namely the soul or the super soul, which is moving these 24 elements. So therefore, if you miss that, then you are in ignorance. You become trapped by these 24 elements. When you enter a vehicle, you should know its purpose. Utilize it, not get stuck up with the vehicle. Suppose you enter the vehicle, suppose you get into a car, and you don't know how to come out of the car. You reach a destination, but you cannot come out of the car. What is the benefit? So the car is meant to reach you to a certain destination. should know its entire operations, not get stuck up with the car. Just like if you sit in the car, it's meant to reach you to a certain destination, you have an important work. Outside the car, car is only a medium to reach you to your destination. So these material elements are only a means for us to reach the supreme goal, Krishna. But if we miss out that and get stuck up and trapped within these material elements, we are lost. Just like sometimes we see students, you know, they get a motorbike or they get a car, keep on roaming. The purpose is, just like the father gives a vehicle to the son to drive to the college, but he is driving it for simply wasting his time and not meeting the purpose for which the vehicle is given. These material elements are created by the Lord to utilize them for the service of the Lord. Use them as a source of liberation, but not as a source of bondage. But that is the art which Lord Kapila is describing. If you miss this art, we mess up everything. We mess up material energy, we mess up our life. We mess up things spiritually, we mess up things materially. Therefore, this presentation by Lord Kapila is very important. The last sentence I would like to share was, Prabhupada has made such esoteric, complicated subjects so simple and so easily understandable. This requires the touch of a genius. I would like to share one statement in this regard of one European famous, internationally famous economist in the 19th century. His name is, and how to pronounce it, it's quite difficult. His name is Schumacher. S-C-H-U-M-A-C-H-E-R, and it's difficult to pronounce any. So he said like this, it's a very interesting statement by him, observation by him. An intelligent fool can make things more complicated and more violent. But it requires the touch of a genius to move in the opposite direction. You see? So that means these subjects are so difficult to understand. Actually, it is a fact. But by the touch of a genius like Prabhupada, even ordinary persons, ignorant persons like us are able to comprehend and fathom such intricate subjects of Bhagavatam, especially Sankhya philosophy. That is expertise. Expertise means what? Not discussing with PhDs and scientists and researchers. No. And conduct a seminar for them. No. Of course, no doubt, we do appreciate that. Expertise means to make a fool an intelligent man. To make an ignorant man an intelligent man. To make a dumb or a dull fellow to understand, you know, very difficult subjects. That is defined as being genius. And Prabhupada personifies this quality. So stop here. Thank you so much. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Shri Prabhupada ki jai.